Today, friends, we are going to add a Knurl texture using Tinkercad, so let's get cracking. We're going to start today super quick at the YouTube channel AZ3Dp. This tutorial right here shows how to add knurling. The creator reached out and showed it to me. It is a fantastic technique that was shared. I'm going to add a link to the video up here in the video. Please take a moment to watch it. It is a nifty explanation. It was made in inches though, and I'm going to switch it to millimeters in just a few minutes. Of course, while you're at the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Also, make sure you give a reaction and please check out the deals that are offered as well. Let's get to the creation. I'm going to have you use a bit.ly and it's Knurl and then Tink because we're knurling in Tinkercad. This leads to a template project I created. Of course, it is set to copy in Tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy in Tinker. Now this M10 thread was created by ZDP189. I've got a full tutorial for that. You can find it using the link right up here. It also has a bit.ly that includes the normal nut on the bottom. I simply copied that in here for this project. If you've never seen how to copy between projects, I've got a tutorial for that as well. Now friends, let's get to the star of the show. This will be unlocked when you see it. It is a simple tool called the SVG Helix. This is what was shown to us by YouTuber AZ3Dp. Now, if you look at this little shape, this is the SVG that I designed. This makes it easier for us to see that we've got this edge aimed in here. So you see it's going to carve a groove. Now, the settings I used for this, I went to the metric version. I'm using 2 14.6. This shape right here, I'm going to unlock it as well, is set to 15 on a side. That's why I've got this set to 14.6. That's how much it's going to cut in. The number of sides, I adjust that all the time because sometimes this shape gets out of whack. I've got the rotation set for negative 90. That's how we got this point aimed right here. And we've got the number of windings for 1. You can see that totally comes up like that. And then I found a separation of 1600 because I wanted this to go above and below the design. Now the copy you have is totally adjustable. I just want to show you if you want the gap bigger. If you type 1700, you'll have to wait a moment for it to arrive, and quite often it'll do something wackadoodle, just like that. But if you wait patient, the design will snap. If you get tired of waiting, this is where you take the 27 and make it 26 and press enter. You could also adjust another number a little bit. You do want to keep the negative 90 because that is what keeps the shape aimed so it's got the cutting edge the way we want. Now friends, the trick works like this. Control D to make a second one. Hit the mirror button and flip it along this axis so they're totally side by side and opposite of each other. I'm going to hide this for a second so this is easier to see. I'm going to grab these two and do Control D, and then I'm going to rotate it 22.5 degrees. You could do less, but I found that 22.5 degrees works really slick. I let go and hit Control D again and again and again until it makes the full circle. It only takes about 16 of them, and you can see it because it gets to that edge and they finally overlap. Right there, you have just filled in all that you need. Maybe one more, and if you overlap, it's not that big a deal, but the more complex it gets, the tougher it is for Tinkercad. That, my friends, is your knurling. Let's bring back all the parts by doing show all. I'm going to select it and I'm going to do L for a line. I want to make sure I've got it middle. Middle. I'm going to make this one the boss and I want it to be middle as well. Let's hit group and see what we made. Note it does take a second, and as you can see, it looks like I have a few less than I need. The knurl worked, but it's just not quite enough. We're going to fix that by simply ungrouping. I'm going to click on one of these and I'm going to lock it. I'm going to click on this piece and I'm going to lock it. I'm going to grab everything else and hit delete. Let's repeat those steps. Once again, unlock and unlock. Control D. Flip. I'm going to shift select those two this time so we can keep the orange one in view. Do Control D. Rotate it to 22.5 degrees. and then just repeat until it goes all the way around. Now that we're all the way around, once again, Control G to group. It is complex. It may take a moment if it pops in air just back out, but holy cow, you have just got a knurled shape. Now, once again, I said this was going to be a knurled M10. I'm going to simply click on this shape, do C for cruising, and I'm going to cruise it on top. Of course, I want to make sure they're aligned. L for align, center, center. And then I don't need this to be as long, so I'm just going to sync it in, grab the two, choose export, and send it as an STL for 3D printing. I'm going to drop it in my 3D modeling folder and call it Knurled M10 version 3 and simply save the changes. Bouncing quickly to Bamboo Lab Studio, let's grab that file. There's our Knurled version 3 and we can simply hit open. Let's do the standard 0.2 settings. Keep everything super simple. Hit slice plate and notice it'll be done in about 17 minutes. And finally, print plate. Send it to the printer, and in no time, we'll be able to see how it turns out. And not too much later, we have got a knurled nut. And of course, here we are with our nifty knurled M10. You can hear the awesome knurled pattern. It's got a great grip. This is a 3D printed thread. And check that out. Awesome project. Once again, huge shout out to ZDP189 for the threads. And AZ3Dp for the knurling. How cool is that? Friends, as I wrap up, I want to say I'm ecstatic how that turned out. I think it's so cool that I had AZ3DP reach out and share the knurling, and then also ZDP189 shared the threads. It's so cool when we can all work together and share knowledge to help everyone become a better tinker. Friends, of course, make sure you take a moment to find AZ3DP using the link up above. Give them a subscription, watch a couple videos, let them know that you appreciate them in the comments. Friends, of course, I want to say thanks to everybody that supported me via YouTube memberships as well. Don't forget, there are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. And one of my favorite perks is you get early access to videos. Friends, I do also want to say thank you to everybody supporting me via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. It has got a fantastic messaging area. Of course, you can use that for free and you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.